I think I said this before, but I need another defunct format, like I need a hole in my head, or like a fat kid needs candy and ice cream. But you might recall I had started out with 8 tracks, picked up a couple today, Partridge Family and the Moody Blues Caught Live plus 5. Probably a mix of live and studio stuff. Then we went to cassettes. And today I picked up not only a crate of 78s, but some albums. Now, I believe that this is how 78s first got their name, or records as we know them today first get their name from 78s. These were called albums. And albums have collections from artists, different themes. You can see we've got some Bing Crosby on the Decca label. And this one is pretty cool. This is complete, Words and Music. This is a soundtrack, and you've got all these MGM stars on it. Judy Garland, Mickey Rooney. But these are albums. So I believe we have the 78 to thank for that name. And I've got a box here. Gosh, there must be maybe 100 of these things. They are heavy as hell. That's a 78. What we're going to do, and we're not going to do any rocket science, brain surgery, open heart surgery. We're not going to send men to the moon. We're simply going to clean some 78s. How are we going to do it? Real simple. Again, not rocket science. Microfiber cloth, non-concentrated dish detergent. The only reason why I got non-concentrated was a guy had posted on eBay a buyer's guide to 78s and how to clean them, and he recommended using non-concentrated. So it could be internet voodoo, but what the heck. Soft bristle dish brush, strainer, and distilled water. Using distilled water probably isn't going to make a hill of beans, but I'm going to use that during the wash, and I'm just going to rinse with simple tap water. It's good enough. So we'll get in the kitchen, clean a few of these things, and see how we do. I don't know what the significance of this is or not, but this is the first 78 I'm going to clean. And we've got Moonlight Serenade by Glenn Miller and his orchestra. Flip side is Sunrise Serenade by Glenn Miller on the Bluebird label. His master's voice. So this thing is ancient. Looks like it's in pretty good physical shape. We've got our distilled water with non-concentrated Dawn. I really don't know if that matters. It's probably internet voodoo, but we've got that stirred up, we've got our strainer, and then we've got our water running. I'm not going to show you cleaning this because, well, a couple of reasons. I can't do it one-handed. Second reason, big reason, is people will jump on me right away and tell me that I'm doing it wrong. So let's put this down for now. We're going to clean it, and then we're going to let these suckers dry. I'll probably do, I don't know, 5 or 6 or so, and see how it goes. So what, if any, lessons did we learn from this cleaning process? Well, these 78s look a hell of a lot cleaner, and I have nothing to compare them in terms of how they'll sound because I've never played one before, but we cleaned a half dozen of them. There's my water. It looks a little gray, not too dirty, but I'll tell you, a lot of dirt came off of these things. And a couple of things that people need to keep in mind when they're cleaning 78s, and I might have mentioned this in the first clip, do not under any circumstances use stuff that you would typically use on your vinyl. So do not use isopropyl, don't use any type of alcohol. Don't use, if you do use ammonia, don't use it. Unlike vinyl, 78s are made out of shellac. And, you know, it's funny, in some regards, shellac seems a lot sturdier than vinyl. And in other regards, it seems more brittle. I don't think these things ever warp. I haven't really seen any scratches on them, so people who kind of OCD over vinyl scratches, fret not with these things. Some simple non-concentrated dishwash soap and some distilled water really seem to do a nice job. So the other lesson I learned is that cheap dollar store strainers really suck. These things really suck. And, you know, I doubt they could even stand up plates, let alone six pieces of shellac. So we're going to try to let these things dry for a while. And then I think we'll give it a spin. But they look really clean. This thing is spinning like a bat out of hell. I just took one of the microfiber cloths and dried this along. This is Glenn Miller's Moonlight Serenade, and we're gonna do a needle drop on this thing in a minute. But I just had a wrestling match with the accelerometer on my iPhone, and the accelerometer almost won. So I think these things are designed to last maybe 2 years or less, and then start causing you problems. Where here we've got this 70, 80 year old technology and spinning away at 78 RPMs. But next step, I'm going to drop the needle on. We'll see how it sounds. Wow, that is awesome. Sure, it's got a few cracks and pops, but man, that is awesome. That is just great. Moonlight Serenade by Glenn Miller. Turn it down before the copyright police go nuts. And my first 78. Spinning like a top. So hope you enjoyed this video. Certainly not meant to be the end-all or do-all for 78s, but this is going to be a heck of a lot of fun. I hope you have fun hunting and spinning down your 78s, and take care for now.